So now let's go back to this figure again over here. So if you look at my processor, you know, I have my core over here, then I have an L1 cache, I have a larger L2 cache, and so on. So, you know, let's say that I have a miss in all of these caches, and I ultimately need to get my data from physical memory. Okay, so now, you know, having the virtual address, so, you know, the core issues are requesting a load something in, and it's always going to refer to the virtual address, okay, because the application and the binary always deal with just virtual addresses, because that is all that is visible to them, right? We're giving them the illusion that they have access to this contiguous 8 gigabytes of space. The application has no idea that these virtual addresses that are being issued ultimately translate into, you know, virtual page numbers, which get mapped to some arbitrary physical page number, right? This is obviously not known at compile time. So the application is issuing these virtual addresses. At runtime, these virtual pages are being mapped to some arbitrary physical page. Okay, so if I do need to get the data from the physical main memory, I have to translate this virtual address to a physical address. Okay, and that translation is being done through this page table that I mentioned. Okay, and these page tables themselves are fairly large structures, right? It has a million entries, and there could be, say, 20 programs running together, so you have, you know, 20 million entries. Each entry needs a few bytes of data. And so if you're talking about capacities that cannot fit in the L2 cache, right, or in the L3 cache. So these page tables are large enough that they have to be stored in memory somewhere. Okay, so let's say that there's a region of memory that is being used and managed by the operating system to store all the page table entries. Okay, so in order to translate the virtual address to a physical address, I first need to read the page table. Once I have the page table, I know that, you know, virtual address ABC is being translated to physical address PQR. Okay, now I can actually issue my request to physical page PQR, get the data, and now the application finally has the data that it needs, right? So just to get, you know, one block of data from memory, I actually need to issue two different reads to memory, one to get the page table translation and one to get the data itself. Okay, so this is, you know, clearly very, very expensive. Okay, and so to avoid this high cost, what is done is that a portion of the page table is stored on the processor in a structure called the TLB. Okay, so let me just blow up the structure over here. So this is called the TLB, which is a translation look-aside buffer, which is a fairly complicated name for something that can also be called a page table cache. Okay, so instead of keeping, so, you know, since the page table has a million entries, it is hard to keep all of it on chip, so only a small portion is being kept in this TLB structure. So the TLB could be, you know, let's say as little as 64 entries. And, you know, one entry over here, for example, says that for process ID 7, virtual page number ABC maps to physical page number PQR. Okay, so if this is a page ABC that has been touched recently, then that translation is being cached in this TLB structure. And so instead of having to go to memory to look up the page table, you can just look up the small structure, which, you know, perhaps takes a single cycle to access. And you can say, well, you know, virtual page number ABC translates to physical page number PQR. Right there I have the physical address that I'm dealing with. So with a single memory access, I can now get my data. Okay, so TLB has a certain coverage. That is, if it has 64 entries and each entry can deal with an 8 kilobyte page, at a time, you're essentially keeping track of translations for 512 kilobytes worth of memory space, right? So you can handle a working set size of 512 kilobytes without ever having a miss in the TLB. If you have a miss in the TLB, then again, you do have to access memory to get the page table translation. Okay, but you know, if you're just dealing with this, with say 512 kilobytes worth of data, the hope is that you will that you will always have a TLB hit, and you won't have to do multiple memory accesses to get your data elements. Okay, so if you want to increase your TLB coverage, one option is to increase the page size. If you went from an 8 kilobyte page size to a 16 kilobyte page size, then your TLB coverage would also grow to 1 megabyte in size. Okay, but then the larger the page size, the more memory space that also gets wasted. So the operating system has to take these into account when it defines the page size. Okay, and, you know, later we'll also talk about a concept of super pages, which allows you to dynamically create larger page sizes. Okay, so let me just do a quick recap before I end this video. So as I said, your application is producing virtual addresses, and each application need not use its entire 8 gigabytes worth of virtual space, right? You're usually using a smaller fraction of that. So if every application that is currently running is using a small fraction of its entire 8 gigabytes of virtual memory space, it's possible that all of that memory fits in physical memory. Okay, so you may not use your swap space on disk if your memory requirement is fairly small. As the memory requirement grows, you will end up needing more pages, and you may end up spilling some pages into the swap space. Okay, so every virtual address gets translated into a physical address. Okay, and that translation is kept track of in the page table, some page table entries are being kept in the TLB. Okay, we are managing the physical memory space as a fully associative cache, so your page could be placed anywhere in physical memory, and the replacement policy is usually least recently used. And the memory disk hierarchy is usually exclusive, and the write policy is almost always write back because of the high cost of doing any disk access. Okay, as I said, the TLB is a small fraction of your page table entries, and it prevents having to do two expensive memory lookups to get one word of data. And by using a large page size, you can also increase the coverage of the TLB. Okay, so in the next video, I'll show you how the TLB and the cache, how those two structures interact with each other.